Hi, this is Alex. In this video, we're going to be looking at the access denied error when trying to connect to a MySQL server. Now, the essential part of connecting to, obviously, to a database and then selecting information from tables is actually, first of all, connecting to the MySQL server. Now, I'm using XAMPP on a Windows machine, so I would already have this installed. I've already got my MySQL installed. So either way, if you're installing MySQL manually or you are, you know, getting it as part of a web server package such as XAMPP, then you will obviously need to connect to your database at some point if you're using databases and database tables to store data. So in this case, to initially connect to a database, we would use the MySQL connect function. Now inside here, this would typically take three parameters. The first one being the server name, the second being the username that you're connecting with, and the third one being the password of the user that you're connecting with. So in this case, and almost all cases, you would use localhost because the script would be on the server that you're trying to connect to, so the MySQL server would be on the same machine. So I'm connecting using localhost. Now if I try and connect with a username that is either not found or a username and password combination that do not match, I'll have this access denied error returned. So the first thing I'm going to go ahead and do is use MySQL connect with the username root and the password as nothing. Now in this case, when I go ahead and refresh my browser, you'll see that we don't have any error appear. Now I have error reporting in php.ini in my php.ini file set to eall. So essentially what this would do is it would return this error anyway. So I can now assume that I have connected successfully to my database. And if we take a look in phpMyAdmin, we can actually take a look at the list of privileges and usernames that are available to us, or users that are available. So I've just gone and clicked on the privileges tab in phpMyAdmin, and you can see here that we've got the users, the host that these users are based on, and the password. Now in this case I'm using root, and this is on 127.0.0.1 and localhost, so I'm connecting successfully to localhost with the username root and with no password. So what happens if I go ahead and I specify another user that doesn't exist, for example Alex? When I do actually go ahead and refresh my page, you see that we have this access denied for user Alex, and that's at localhost because that's the server that we've defined, and it says here using password no. Now if you were to go ahead and connect using a user that did have a password and you didn't actually supply a password, it would obviously say using password no, but the problem there would be that you are not supplying a password when you have to. So let's go ahead and change this back to root, and I'm going to go ahead and supply a password. So I'm just going to type in password here. Now in this case I'm supplying a password when the password in here is nothing. We don't have a password set on this user. So now when I go ahead and refresh, it says access denied for user root at localhost using password yes. So although I've supplied a password, it doesn't match the null value that's stored in the MySQL permissions list or privileges list. So in this case, you can go ahead with phpMyAdmin and quite easily add a new user. Obviously, if you're uploading PHP files that are accessing a database on a remote server, so for example, web hosting that you might use, you'll need to be careful with this because different usernames look different on different servers. So for example, let's just go ahead and get rid of this. Let's just say you had hosting and your username to log into your cPanel, for example, if you had cPanel available, was, for example, my website. You may need to define your username as my website underscore root, and then obviously go ahead and just define the password that you've set. So there are a lot of other or a lot of alternative ways that usernames are created and how they look, and obviously it's up to you to set your own password. Working on a local server, it doesn't really matter if we don't have a password, as long as you're not allowing people externally to access your server. So in this case, with root and no password, I've connected successfully. However, if you do get the access denied error, it's simply a case that your username and password do not match, or you're using a user that doesn't exist, or you're not using a password at all.